Anyone who desires to be ignorant and free desires what never was and never will be. Let me quote Thomas Jefferson again. Anyone who desires to be ignorant and free desires what never was and never will be. When Jefferson, the principal author of the Declaration of Independence, wrote these words, he was expressing a truth that relatively few Americans appreciate today. You see, an elected or appointed official is required to take an oath to defend the Constitution of both his state and the United States. His job, then, is to follow his oath. Fair enough, but what if he doesn't know what the Constitution says? How can he do his job? And what about the rest of us? What is our job? As citizens of our state or of these United States, our job is to hold him accountable to his oath of office. But how can we do this if we don't know what the Constitution says or what it means? If we don't know the rules, then how can we tell if they are being followed? If we don't know these essential elements of citizenship, what used to be called civics, then it's kind of difficult to object to things like unconstitutional wars or unconstitutional bailouts or the ratification of trade agreements that rob us not only of American jobs, but also of American sovereignty. It's kind of hard to raise an intelligent argument against unconstitutional sobriety checks or even torture tactics if we don't know the rules and the principles on which they are based. In short, if we are ignorant, it's not long before we won't be free.
This is Michael Anthony Peruca for Institute on the Constitution, bringing you the American View.